CIET NCERT presents the series Stories Tell Many a Thing. Stories for young learners of English at primary level. The major purpose of this series is to provide exposure to English language through oral means. Welcome to this series and a happy listening.
Stories tell many a thing. Stories for young learners of English. Hello children. Do you like to listen to stories? I know you all like stories. Stories about tiger, lion, cat, dog, kings, queens, common man, farmers, carpenters, postmen, policemen and policewomen, teachers and so on. Let's now listen to stories of various kinds. Stories which will make you open your mouth and stop your breathing for a while and make you laugh from your heart. So listen to the stories and think about the ideas, animals, men and women in the stories, and then tell your friends, papa, mama, little sister and brother in your language and in English. Come on, let's get into the world of stories.
The miser, a rich man. Do you know what a miser does? Why does a miser love his or her money more than anything else in life? A miser is one who does not want to spend his money. Listen to a story about a miser and his actions. Just a minute. Before listening, think about the words. Lend, borrow, tinkle of coins.
Once there was a very rich man. He was a miser. He ate very cheap food and spent very little money. He lent money to small shopkeepers at a high interest. In this way, he earned a lot of money. Every morning, he went out to see the shopkeepers and came home at midday.
The miser had a watchman to look after his house. The watchman lived in a hut near the gate. He liked fish, and his wife cooked it for him every day. The watchman told his wife, "Cook the fish before the midday. Our master will be out then. He does not eat meat or fish, and he will not like the smell of fish."
One day the master came home early. He walked past the watchman's hut and caught the smell of a fish. It was a nice smell and he liked it very much.
That afternoon, he called the watchman and asked him, "What were you cooking today?"
The watchman said quickly, "I won't do it again, sir. Please excuse me."
The miser said, "Don't be afraid. I am not angry. What was your wife cooking? Please tell me."
The watchman said, "We were cooking fish."
The miser said, "Please cook it every day. I like the smell very much."
The watchman and his wife thought, "Our master is mad." But they cooked fish every day.
After a month, one evening the watchman and his wife came to see their master.
"Sir, you like the smell of fish," the watchman said to his master. "So, we cook it every day. But fish is not cheap. It is very dear. It costs us a lot of money. I earn only 30 rupees a month. So please give us money for fish."
The miser thought for a while. Then he said, Oh, all right. Wait here. He went into his room and shut the door behind him. He took out some silver coins from a bag. He dropped them one by one on the floor. The watchman and his wife heard the tinkle of the coins and were very happy. They said, "He is going to give us all that money."
After some time, their master came out and sat down on a chair. He then asked the watchman and his wife, "Did you hear the tinkle of the coins?"
"Yes, sir, we did," said the watchman.
"Did you enjoy it?" asked the miser.
"Yes, sir," said the watchman and his wife.
The miser then said, "All right, I enjoyed the smell of your fish and you enjoyed the sound of my coins. I don't ask for your fish, so you don't ask for my money. Now go away."
Having listened to the story of the miser, now think, do you want to be a miser? I can hear you say a big no. Now let us tell the story together. I want you to repeat after me.
Once there was a very rich man. He was a miser. He ate very cheap food and spent very little money. He lent money to small shopkeepers at a high interest. In this way, he earned a lot of money. Every morning, he went out to see the shopkeepers and came home at midday. The miser had a watchman to look after his house. The watchman lived in a hut near the gate. He liked fish and his wife cooked it for him every day. The watchman told his wife, "Cook the fish before the midday. Our master will be out then. He doesn't eat meat or fish and he will not like the smell of fish." One day, the master came home early. He walked past the watchman's hut and caught the smell of fish. It was a nice smell and he liked it very much. That afternoon, he called the watchman and asked him, "What were you cooking today?" The watchman said quickly, "I won't do it again. Sir, please excuse me." The miser said, "Don't be afraid. I am not angry. What was your wife cooking? Please tell me." The watchman said, "We were cooking fish." The miser said, "Please cook it every day. I like the smell very much." The watchman and his wife thought, "Our master is mad." But they cooked fish every day. After a month, one evening the watchman and his wife came to see their master. "Sir, you like the smell of fish?" The watchman said to his master, "So we cook it every day. But fish is not cheap. It is very dear. It costs us a lot of money. I earn only 30 rupees a month. So please give us money for fish." The miser thought for a while. Then he said, "Oh, all right. Wait here." He went into his room and shut the door behind him. He took out some silver coins from a bag. He dropped them one by one on the floor. The watchman and his wife heard the tinkle of the coins and were very happy. They said, "He is going to give us all that money." After some time, their master came out and sat down on a chair. He then asked the watchman and his wife, "Did you hear the tinkle of the coins?"
"Yes, sir, we did," said the watchman.
"Did you enjoy it?" asked the miser.
"Yes, sir," said the watchman and his wife.
The
The miser then said, "All right, I enjoyed the smell of your fish and you enjoyed the sound of my coins. I don't ask for your fish, so you don't ask for my money. Now go away."
The miser, a rich man.
Friends, you were just listening to this program. Concept and Academic Coordination, Dr. R. Meghanathan. Artists, Ashok Ojha and Rajshree Trivedi. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo. Guidance, Ajit Horo. Produced by Vimlesh Chaudhary. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi.